Welcome back, everybody, to Small Press Expo 2012. I'm Joe, and that's...
I'm Rusty.
And that's...
I'm James Pointe-Jour, first time here in SPX. Thrilled to be here.
We're thrilled to have you, James.
Yes.
So this is your first time in SPX, but you attended last year?
I attended last year, basically just to come out, you know, check out some artists, buy some comics, have a good time. I thought it was so awesome that basically I wanted to come back and do it, you know, as an exhibitor, and, you know, make mini comics.
Yeah, you know, this show inspires you to make comics, and it's awesome because it basically, it generates its own exhibitors.
Yeah. Like, I've been drawing, I've been drawing comics and cartoons since I was a little kid. And while I love superheroes and all that, I also like, you know, DuckTales, the Carl Banks stuff, Calvin and Hobbes. And I noticed that Small Press Expo has basically more cartoons that I loved growing up. So, yeah, like, it's awesome. So I figured this one is the one I wanted to be part of first, you know, let's try it out.
Is this your first time exhibiting?
First time exhibiting anywhere ever, yeah.
That's awesome.
That's fantastic.
Yeah, and so far it's great. I'll definitely be back next year. Met a lot of fun, interesting people. Everyone's super nice. It was just cool.
You know, you bring your book here, and then as soon as the show ends, and you're like, I'm going to make 1,000 comics this week.
That was kind of how it happened. Yeah. Like, I hadn't, I went to school for animation and worked in that for a bit. I work as a graphic designer now. Comics kind of became like a web-only thing, and I would do it here and there. When I came here last year, basically just as a fan, I just got super pumped and began drawing, like, incessantly. And so, yeah, here I am. So
that's awesome.
Great. Yeah, it's great. So
yeah, we've always talked about how, like, that first week after SPX, you don't want to do anything but make comics.
Yeah.
It's unbelievable.
Yeah. So. It's like, you're just addicted.
Yeah.
Basically. Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, you almost overdose on comics enthusiasm.
Yes.
Yeah. And then you're out of it, and you're like, I'm going to continue it on my own.
Yeah,
and then,
right.
But then a week after, the
like
crash
this comic
comes,
days.
Right. And then you hate comics and leaving you alone for too long. Yeah. Damn you, SPX. Why are you so far away?
Where is everybody?
Yeah, the withdrawal is kind of brutal, but you work through it. Yeah.
So. When you have so many people around, they're all like, hey, look at the comics. Let's look at comics. Talk about comics. And then there's nobody around, and you're just like, son of a bitches.
Right.
Where'd you go?
It's ridiculous.
Leave me alone.
I don't care about comics.
Yeah.
So tell us about your comics.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, I'm actually here with two. First one is called Rockford. And I don't think you can talk about the style, but I'm kind of aping Bill Watterson because, again, Calvin and Hobbes, kind of thing I loved growing up. And it's basically all about road trips, you know, the best road trips ever. So in every issue, Rockford, you know, goes on a road trip for some outlandish or mundane reason, whatever.
That's the perfect reason for a road trip.
I think so.
Like in real life, too. So.
Yes, yeah. I agree. In this case, he's trying to impress a girl. He's going to a dance party. But he doesn't know how to dance. So the road trip here is he travels to the mountain lair of the Dance King to you pick up some new moves and just become an awesome dancer. So
I think this sounds like a great comic already.
Thank you. Yeah.
What else do you have here?
And the other one here, this is a children's book that a friend of mine, Missy Hodges, wrote. And she got me to illustrate it for her. And basically it's about a little girl who it's her bedtime. But for some reason, she can't go to bed. Like, for some reason, she keeps being interrupted by animals, like, just happen to pop by her room.
Right.
Her dad thinks she's making it up, but she swears it's real. So, basically, yeah, it's a story about, you know, what she says, what she claims is keeping her awake. So, a bunch of opinionated animals, blah, coming by and interrupting her.
Rusty and I are roommates, and I often have a trouble where he will just come by in the middle of the night just making like animal noises. And
right.
It's like, and I tell people and they don't believe me, they don't think he's real.
Right.
And it's like, it's really unfortunate that happens.
So he's like, are you like the Snuffleupagus? Like, you know, everyone.
That's exactly what he's like. Yeah. He's the Rustleupagus.
Right.
And,
just has to do it.
We have a multi-part series. Like on Sesame Street, Snuffleupagus, when his arc was like a month where he just didn't exist.
Yeah.
And people were like, oh, Big Bird, you seriously have mental issues.
Yeah.
You should really go talk to somebody.
It's pretty heavy stuff for a children's
Talk to the Green Grocer, please.
Yeah,
he wants to help you.
Right.
And then eventually everybody saw him. And did anybody apologize to Big Bird? I don't know. I don't think so.
Probably I don't not. Think so.
They didn't want to fess up to it.
Yeah.
No.
They're all too proud. They're like, oh, he's real. Well, let's not say anything to him.
Oh, fine.
Yeah.
Right.
Like,
you
whatever.
Know what, Big Bird? Blame yourself for being so weird in the first place, or else we would have believed you.
Right.
You put yourself in this situation,
Big
Bird.
Yeah, you're a 6-year-old and you live alone. Like, where are your parents, man?
You live outside amongst trash.
Yeah. Right, right.
I mean, come on now.
Yeah.
This homeless educational stretch of street is wrong.
I do now think that Oscar the Grouch is a metaphor for homelessness.
Right.
Yeah.
Well, he seems proud of it, though. Like, you know,
right, he's accepted it.
Oh, yeah. He's
for all the good and bad that comes with it.
Yeah, you know, his best
friend's
a worm.
He can't vote.
He doesn't vote.
You know, he doesn't have an address. Yeah. It's terrible.
He doesn't care. Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
He just makes the most.
He does. He's his own man.
Yeah.
Or Grouch.
Do you have any plans for any future books yet?
Yeah, I'll probably do a second one of Rockford here. I'm not sure what the story's going to be yet. Maybe I shouldn't say that on camera. But,
no, definitely say that on camera.
That's exciting.
Everybody would be surprised.
It could be anything.
Right, yeah. Yeah, it could definitely be anything. I know I might do something as mundane as them. They're going to check out a band, and you know, they meet the band. You know, I don't know, they're stranded on the side of the road, and they help them get to the show on time or something like that.
Yeah, I mean, mundane things end up can be amazing as long as the detail, you know.
Yeah.
It's never about the destination. It's,
yeah.
It's a journey.
Because it's like, what do you do with this mundane thing? Yeah,
yeah. Yeah. So yeah, there'll be more Rockford in the future, and we'll be pimping Missy's book throughout the rest of the year, and we'll just see what happens. Yeah.
Very cool.
Do you have an online home where people can look at your stuff or contact you?
You can actually check out previews of both books on coffeeroll.com. It's coffee, ROLL.com. And I'm on Tumblr, finally, because of SPX.
Nice.
And that's jmpointdujour.com.
So, oh, that's fantastic.
Right. Yeah.
And, I'm sure your followers may not increase like dramatically, but you at least get one or two.
I might get one or two.
Yeah,
and
I mean,
that's
yeah.
fine.
Yeah, you know what
I
mean?
Yeah, yeah. That's right. Yeah, I am on Twitter too. Also jmpointdujour.com. Jmpointdujour. Yeah. And yeah, just check me out.
Now, before you go, we have a mystery bag of mystery questions.
Okay.
And you're welcome to dip your hand into this.
Okay.
We can't, we make no promises of what the questions will be.
Yes.
All right.
Granted, we created them, but we don't know what you're going to pull out.
Yeah. All right. Let's grab any one here.
Yes.
Any one.
Okay. Here we go. Oh, dude, I love these. Like, little 25 cent things I used to get as a kid.
Yeah. They're fun to open, too.
Yeah.
Oh,
professionally. Here we go. I'm not sure who's asking this.
Okay.
I'm not sure who's asking me this.
Well, what does the question say?
The question is, will you marry me? And I'm wondering, I don't know which one of you is that. If it's
if
both
that,
of you, I don't know if that's legal anymore. But
so, who do you?
But the question is.
Which one?
No. It's going to be
you. It's Rusty.
It's Rusty? It's well, dude, I live in a small one-bedroom apartment, two-bedroom apartment with my little sister, my kid sister. And the only food we have is coffee, so.
It's understandable.
I'm sorry.
Yeah.
So,
no,
you know
I mean, that's
what?
Fine.
You put your heart out there, and
are
this
you,
is, it's,
you,
it happens.
Wait, are you turning me down, Rusty? Is that what happened? Or are you, no, you're asking me.
I'm asking you.
You're asking me, okay.
I mean, I guess I could rescind the offer. That
you could
the
rescind
ball's
the
in your court, well, sir.
Let me ask, what kind of dowry are you bringing to the table, Rusty?
Rusty has a collection of hats.
I do.
It's a pretty nifty hat.
And a cow,
he has
I guess.
About 12 of them.
Yeah. 12 of them?
Yeah, is that right?
Yeah. Actually, 12? No. Like 16 now.
16.
16 hats.
Various colors. He has a really nice blue one, a red one.
Do you have the little like fedora from Indiana Jones, the brown Indiana Jones fedora?
I do not have a plain brown.
Yeah. Oh, deal breaker. Well, oh my gosh. This is so awkward.
I'm sorry, man. That kind of would
have been. So anyway, it was nice talking to you.
Yeah.
It's just for the best. It's for the best.
It's fine. It's
thanks so
fine,
much for sitting down with us.
We can keep dating. I mean,
that'll be good.
That'll be good.
Right. I hear Rusty's really good at dating. If you would,
so now,
you know
now
what
I need to find Indiana Jones.
Yeah. Thanks for having.
Yeah,
thanks
I don't
for talking with
him
us.
Leave him. So
no,
I think we should keep. I think we should explore.
If you can simply love him, you got leaps and bounds above everybody else in his life.
So much more than I've ever received from anyone else.
Well, it'd be great if you'd stop. You know. Visiting Joe in the middle of the night.
Yeah,
you know,
that's
true.
Trust me,
making me jealous.
I'm my own worst enemy, really. So.
Yeah.
Like I don't know. Yeah, like, I don't know if you're you know loyal or not. So
yeah.
Oh, he's loyal, but to himself.
I set myself up on this.
he only cares about himself.
Yes,
he'll
so
never betray his own
never
wishes.
Betray his own.
Yeah, ever.